Hello, I'm Kathryn from Sharetribe, and in this video, we'll learn what custom listing fields are, how to add different types of fields and filters in console, and how custom listing fields and filters work for your users. Custom listing fields are information about listings that's specific to what your marketplace offers. Your providers add this information when creating a listing, and your customers can use the information in these fields to filter search results. Together with listing categories, listing fields let you create dynamic search experiences. So let's learn how to add custom listing fields. To get started, navigate to Listings and Listing Fields in Console. To start creating a new field, click Add a new custom listing field. First, you're asked to enter a field name and an ID. The field name is visible to users as the name of this field when they're creating a listing or filtering search results. The field ID is a unique identifier of this custom field that's not shown to users, but is an important part of the listing's data. Next, you choose the field type. The options are free text, number, select one, and select multiple. Below the field type, you will determine further settings. First, you choose whether the field is mandatory to fill or not. Next, you can determine optional listing type and category settings, if you want the listing field to be limited to listings in a specific type or category only. Copy a listing type ID or category ID here, and this field will only be available when someone creates a listing in that type or category. Finally, there's a section for search settings, which vary depending on the field type you choose. So let's create some actual custom fields. We'll create a custom field in each of the types. You can use the chapter markers in the video timeline to skip to the relevant one for you. We'll start with free text. This field type is a freeform text field that providers will fill. It's great for asking for specific open details about a listing. For example, you could ask about previous work experience on a job board or a URL to a freelancer's portfolio on a design service marketplace. For my example bike rental marketplace, I'll use the free text field for maintenance history. I'll fill in the name and ID, maintenance history, and choose free text as the field type. This will be an optional field, which means I'll leave this box unchecked. I also won't limit this field to any specific type or category, since my marketplace only has bikes at this point. In the search settings, you can decide if your marketplace's keyword search will return listings based on the contents of this field. For my marketplace, I'll enable it. On to the next custom field. Now, we'll create a number field, which is a field that accepts whole numbers only from a predetermined range. My example will be the bike's year of manufacture, so I'll add the name and an ID, and choose the number field type. This will also be an optional field, so I won't enable the setting make this field mandatory. Next, I'm asked to determine a minimum and maximum value. The oldest bikes I accept on my marketplace will be from 1900. The newest bikes will be from the current year, which at the time of recording is 2024. In the search settings, I can choose if I want to add this field as a search filter. I choose yes. This means there will be a number slider on my search page for customers to filter with. I'll make the field a secondary filter, meaning it will be nested under more filters on the search page when using the map layout, and on a grid search page, it will be placed after categories and any primary filters. Next, we'll create a Select One field. So click to add a new field. The Select One field type is a drop-down selection where the provider chooses one option of many. On my example marketplace, this field will be for the bike's brand. I'll add a name and an ID and then choose Select One as the field type. I'll make the field mandatory, meaning providers will need to pick an option when creating a listing. And speaking of which, we'll need to add some options. There are two default ones, which we'll edit first. Fill in an option name and an ID. These work pretty much the same as the field name and ID. The name is visible to users, and the ID is a unique identifier beneath the hood. After editing the two default options, click to add as many options as you'll need. I'll speed things up here with a bit of editing magic. Below the options, you can again determine if this field can be used as a search filter. I'll enable it, which means that customers can filter search results based on the field options, and I'll make this a secondary filter. And finally, we're adding a Select Multiple field. This will be a checkbox selection, where providers can choose one or more out of the provided options. So add a new field and enter in a name and an ID. Mine will be Accessories. Click Select Multiple in the field type selection. If you make this field type mandatory, providers will need to choose at least one of the options. If it's not mandatory, they can opt to choose none. So I'll make this field non-mandatory. Another setting to configure is if you want the unselected options to be shown on the listing page. When enabled, customers can see the options that are not included in addition to the ones that are. If disabled, customers will only see the options that are included. For my marketplace, I'll disable the field. Next, you'll edit and add as many options as you need and fill in the name and an ID for each. For my accessory options, I'll add bell, lights, lock, and mudguard. I'll also want this field to be available as a search filter for customers and make it a secondary filter. You can reorder the listing fields and options within fields by order of importance by clicking on the 6 dots next to a field card and dragging them up and down. This order determines the order of the fields in listing creation and on the search page. Finally, click Save and your listing fields are now ready to go. Let's see how they will look like for your users. Log in as a user on your test marketplace. Click to post a listing. You can see all our custom fields added on the details page below the title and description. A provider then fills them in and gets notified if something mandatory is missing. After adding everything, they can move forward in the listing creation flow. Customers, on the other hand, can filter search results by field data to narrow down the selection. Depending on your search page layout, the filters will either be above the selection or on the left side next to the listings. If you create category-specific filters, they will only be shown after a customer chooses a category. So that's our listing fields. Let's recap. Custom listing fields are information about listings that's specific to what your marketplace offers. The different types of listing fields and filters in Sharetribe are free text, number, select one, and select multiple. You can also use listing fields as search filters, creating dynamic experiences together with categories for your customers. Thanks for watching.